Okay, so in this video, I'm going to start off talking about the two kinds of statistics. At a broad level anyway, statistics ends up taking on lots of different definitions. And the first kind of statistics I want to talk about are descriptive statistics. All right, so these descriptive statistics are numbers that summarize data. All right, so for example, the average height of American women is a descriptive statistic, and it summarizes the height of all American women. The other main kind of statistics is called inferential statistics, right? And these are processes that allow, I don't know who to say, scientists to make decisions about populations based on data from samples. So for example, is it the case that SUU women are taller or shorter than all American women? If we just have a sample of SUU women, we could run some inferential statistics on that data and make a decision about whether or not SUU women are taller or shorter than American women are more generally. So two critical ideas in statistics are the idea of a population. All right, a population is all individuals about whom we want to make make a claim. For example, we might want to make a claim about all American women, right? And oftentimes, though, in research, we can't measure everybody in the population. Instead, we measure a sample, which is a subset of a population that is in our study. So for example, I might do a study and I might have 30 SUU undergraduate women in my sample. Even though I want to have all women in the whole US, what I end up with is 30 SUU women in my sample. All right, so when we're doing research, we want to know about a population, right? Who the people we're making our claim about, population. And so maybe I'll draw a little circle for each person in the population. All right, so imagine this is all American women that are there, right? And let's say we are interested in their height, the average height of all American women, right? And so the symbol for the mean of a population is mu, right? So that is a population mean. Mu is a population mean. Right, so we want to know the mean of all of these women. Hope I should make this one. Unfortunately for us, we can't get all American women into our lab here at SUU. So what we do is we work with a sample. All right, and so this is from the population. It's a subset, so we'll just say we end up getting those folks. Right, and ideally, it's a random sample. Right, and a random sample would mean that every individual in this population has an equal chance of being in our sample. In practice, that's not usually how it works, but ideally, that's how it would work. Right, and so before, what we want to do is find out the average height of American women. Right, we want to measure all of these women's heights, all of the individual women's scores, and calculate the average of that that score. But what we have is some SUU women, and we can calculate their average height. So X with a bar across the top, it's called X bar. That is a sample mean, right? So we want to know the population mean, but we don't have access to all the people in the population. So we have a subset of that population that came into our lab. We measure their height, and we have their height, the sample's mean. And then what we're going to do is we're going to guess the population mean based on our sample mean, right? And this is an inference we're making. In fact, this is a type of inferential statistics. And when you use a sample mean as your best guess at a population mean, that's a point prediction, the point being the population mean in this case. All right, so there's a couple more little details here that are of interest. Right, these are descriptive statistics. So these are numbers that summarize a data set. Right, so this sample mean summarizes the sample data, and this population mean sample summarizes the population data. So these are descriptive statistics, right? And when we make this inference, that's a process that we're going through, and this is an inferential statistical process that we're going through there. And notice that the population mean, this is a Greek letter, right? And that's going to be commonly the case, that most population statistical values like this are going to be Greek letters, descriptive statistics, and most sample statistics are going to be Roman letters, an X or something like that. So for example, if you measure all of the heights of the women in our sample, and X bar, their sample mean is 5'7", right? And we want to know the population mean, the average height of all American women, and we don't know. The inferential process here is to just take the sample mean and use that as your guess at the population mean, right? So the point prediction here for the population mean is the same as whatever the sample mean was. And that's our best guess at the population mean, given the information that we have. Right. Ideally, we would measure all of the people in the population. In that case, it's called a census. But since we couldn't do that, we just had a sample. And that's our best guess at the population mean, is whatever our sample mean was. All right.